Shepard's going to bring it back tonight, called I'll Wash My Face in the Morning Dew. Would you please welcome Gene Shepard?
The first strange town I was ever in, the county was hanging a man. Nobody cared if he lived or died, and I just didn't understand.
Vern.
Yeah, come right
ahead, Vern.
No, I thought if you wanted to model, I'd come over here with you. You want to show your jacket off?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
I'm not a very good model.
All right, let's turn around. It's a great big clown on the back. Now, what is the significance of this?
Well, we make these.
We?
Well, I don't make them. The lady that works for me by the name of Tootie Clammer, she does all of these things. She's done some work for Bill Anderson and a few of the other people around town, and she does a beautiful job. All you got to do is just send her a picture, and she'll put anything on a jacket or anything you want.
Now, is this, excuse me, Vern, would you move over, please? We want to sit.
I like that one.
Are you telling me you're, I'm going to give you this.
Okay.
Are you telling me you're in the stage clothes business?
Kind of. We don't just necessarily make them for people that are in the show business. We'll make them for anybody.
Somebody that wants to be colorful.
As long as they got $300.
You know that Jeannie and I are the same age, exactly.
Yep.
65.
Speak for yourself.
I don't mind confessing, do you? No, we are the same age.
Back that up 10 years. You got it made.
We are the same age.
Yeah.
Are you writing a book about Roy Orbison?
No, well, actually, my husband worked for Roy and was, the last 6 years.
Who, Benny?
Yes. He was Roy's, the dearest friend. If anybody didn't know Roy and Benny, they would think they was a little odd, you know. But it was a total...
What do you mean by that?
Because it was I've never seen two men love one another the way Benny and Roy loved one another. It was a total... It was just a total beautiful relationship between two men.
Mm-hmm.
And Benny is writing a book. I'll probably put in a few little things along the way.
So what did Benny do with Roy?
He drove Roy's bus, and he sold Roy's product on the road. And Roy had just left our house about 2 hours before he passed away. He always stayed with us when he came to Nashville.
So you got to have one of the final conversations with him.
Oh, yes. And we had a beautiful relationship.
What kind of mood was he in?
He was great. They had come in the morning before, and Roy had lost about 30 pounds. And I peeked out the bathroom window in my bedroom. It shows out the front. And Roy got around. You know, Roy had moved to Malibu, California.
Mm-hmm.
And Roy liked the weather in California. I don't know if he really liked California that much, but Nashville, he considered Nashville his home. And he got out and he looked around, you know, and he comes through the door and he opens his coat and he goes, ta-da. And he looked really great. He'd lost about 30 pounds. And I said, we called him the kid. I said, you look great, kid. And he said, I feel great. And I said, well, welcome home. And big tears come in his eyes. And he said, it's real good to be home. And he spent that night with us, and the next day, and the next night he went to spend with his mother. And that's where he passed away.
Now, this may sound like a dumb question, but I'm going to ask it anyway. In a casual setting, did he take the glasses off?
He didn't wear the dark glasses. He wore just the plain glasses, you know.
But I guess he only wore the dark glasses on stage, right?
Yes, and that was kind of a fluke. He went overseas one time, and he had lost his clear glasses, and the only thing he had with him was the sunglasses, so he just wore them on the whole trip, so it kind of became a trademark with him.
Oh, I see.
But
okay.
Anybody that... I just consider it a pleasure to have known Roy Orbison. A lot of people thought he was stuck up, and But he was kind of a shy person, but he had the greatest sense of humor in the world.
Boy, yeah.
And we've got some funny stories about Roy Orbison.
we're going to take it. Is there one you can tell on this show?
Yeah. Oh, there's quite a few.
All right, we may come back to this.
They're not dirty. We didn't know no rot on Roy because he was a class A guy.
I don't think I've ever heard anything bad about him. I appreciate the fact that Goodies from over in Winston-Salem sponsors this show. I keep hoping this show is not giving you a headache, but I want you to use the product. Nashville Now is brought to you by Goodies Headache Powders. Goodies provides fast pain relief with the most effective combination of ingredients you can buy. By the way, if you change the channels, I guarantee you get a headache. You'll need this.
We use these.
Let me go back to the cue here. With the most effective combination of ingredients you can buy without a prescription. Goodies.